Today I would like to present the experience of a couple from Kabale in Amhara National Regional State, northwestern part of Ethiopia. The name of the couple are Mrs. Workanesh Asafa and Mr. Balai Mazengia. These couples are from Maha gender in Wash Model Village. They registered a very good achievement regarding ensuring gender equality in their household. So I would like to present in three areas. The first one is the previous part, the previous situation, that is before Erwash intervention in the village looks like. The situation for Mrs. Workanesh Asafa was difficult like other women colleagues in her village because of the patriarchal attitude of the community in her village, which restricted her and other women to get wash information. As a result, she had a limited wash information because she had no exposure to attend trainings about, for example, water-related diseases or using from unprotected sources. So she didn't have the necessary information regarding keeping the hygiene and sanitation of her family. As a result, her family were vulnerable to different types of waterborne disease. Besides, she had a burden of supplying and managing water at the household level. She spent many hours in search of water, especially during the dry months. It was very difficult to fetch water for her, especially to carry the pot during pregnancy. It was a challenge. Besides, they were quarrels with other women during the dry seasons in search of water. And the other challenge for Mrs. Workanesh Asafa was discussing about menstrual hygiene was a taboo in her village. Also, it was not a habit to use pants for women. Besides, there were domestic violence at the household level. There was an incident twice. She was beaten by her husband because of disagreement, because he spent many hours in attending a training. She didn't recognize the importance of the training. As a result, there was a challenge for her. Besides, for women, due to cultural constraints, it was unusual to defecate during the daytime. This was a challenge for her. Besides, sometimes their children went to school with empty stomachs because of the gender division of labor. Her husband considered this cooking as well as serving children was her responsibility. As a result, children went to school with empty stomachs. So this picture shows that they used it from an unprotected source. After identifying all these challenges, the project, in collaboration with local partners, this is the government institutions, the Women's Affairs Office, and the Water Energy and Irrigation Office, together we planned to establish a model village to fully implement the integrated wash approaches and bring gender issues at the center of this wash implementation activities. As a result, we had arranged a structuring trainings for couples in which the husband and the wife attended the trainings together this was unusual for them. As a result, this was an eye-opener for the couples. Besides, refresher trainings were given, and Mrs. Workanesh Asafa is a WASCO secretary, and she got WASCO trainings on different issues. Gender is at the center of this training. So this opened their eyes to know about gender equality and gender as a social construct and can be changed. Besides, the project also arranged an experience sharing visit to a village known as Auramba. That village is an egalitarian village. There is no division of tasks. They are a model in many, especially in empowering women. No division of tasks. They are a model in managing water structures, in hygiene and sanitation issues, in social equity issues. So they are a model. This helped us, especially men, to change their minds translating the training and experience sharing after they returned to their village. Also, community discussions and these dialogues among the model villagers helped to discuss so many things. When they returned to their village, they constructed a discussion hall, and monthly they met there and discussed so many things, including water, how to keep the safety of water quality, water point management, gender equality issues, hygiene and sanitation issues, all these issues reinvented in the community meetings. This helped to change their attitudes and translate what they have learned and got from the experience sharing easy. Now, there are so many changes in the lives of Mr. Balai Mazenge and Mrs. Workanesh Asafa. Now there is a mutual respect and understanding at the household level. He started to help his wife in getting water from the newly constructed hand dug well. Besides, he started to care his children, which was unusual before the trainings and the experience sharing visit. No domestic violence. Now she is free to move. But after discussing every issue raised and discussing between the husband and the wife, she can release during the daytime because they constructed an improved latrine and no problem for her and people and her community to release themselves during the daytime. Totally, there are so many achievements observed in this village. 8 households which were known for domestic violence in this village, now there are no domestic violence. There is mutual understanding, there is a check and balance among the community. If there is domestic violence in their community, so women started to participate in decision making activities, in WASCO activities. For example, Mrs. Workanesh Asafa is a secretary of the WASCO, and she raised an issue specially to arrange a fetching time for disadvantaged people, that is elderly people, to fetch on their own time and accepted by the community members. So they started to play active role in WASCO management activities. They also participated in community audit, that is auditing all the WASH performance, WASH implementation process, and they participated and they showed their active participation in the WASH management issues. So this contributed for sustainability of the WASH services achieved in their village. That is all for me. Thank you very much for listening.